much for taking some time out to join us for the Black Library Warhammer preview online. How are you?
I'm good. It's great to be here again.
Indeed. It comes around so fast. So what can you exclusively reveal to us that you've been working on, not recently, but to be released soon enough?
The next thing for me that's coming out is Sigismund, the Eternal Crusader.
Fantastic. So that's going to be released at the Black Library Celebration 2022.
It is.
Who is Sigismund?
During the Horus Heresy and the Great Crusade, Sigismund was the first captain of the Imperial Fists and the Lord Templar, which basically means that he's in charge of the Imperial Fist Templars, who at that time, what they did was they guarded the Temple of Oaths, and they are incredibly elite, even amongst the Imperial Fists. And then in particular, at the end of the Horus Heresy, during the Siege of Terror, Sigismund is well known for being made the first Emperor's Champion. He then goes on to found, during the Second Founding, he's the first commander of the Chapter of the Black Templars, which is one of the successor Templars of the Imperial Fists.
You're quite well known, I think, for your fondness for writing about various Imperial Fists characters and personalities. And you've certainly written about Sigismund during the Horus Heresy and the Siege of Terror.
Yeah, it's turned out that way.
He's someone you're quite familiar with. What period of his life does the Eternal Crusader cover?
The Eternal Crusader actually is, it's almost like a short biography that takes you through all of his life up until the end of the Great Crusade. And it does that through a series of like these key pivotal points in his life. The whole book is framed by a remembrancer who goes specifically to find Sigismund to ask him a question. And the question is, why has Sigismund said quite openly that he believes that in the future there will be only war? Because at this point, the Horus Heresy hasn't happened. Horus has been declared war master to finish the Great Crusade, which in most people's minds is almost done. Why does Sigismund believe differently? And I'm hoping that when you read the book, what you'll come away with is a sense of exactly why Sigismund is the way he is. And also you get to see a lot of things which I'm sure fans of the Imperial Fist and of the Horus Heresy will really enjoy reading about.
When the Horus Heresy series first began, I think there was quite a few elements of dramatic irony where people who are familiar with the Imperium of the 41st millennium could see some kind of Easter eggs, essentially, things that were the germination, some things that we took for granted by the time of the 41st millennium. Is setting stories before the Horus Heresy, does that give you an opportunity to play on people's understanding now of the Horus Heresy itself? Is there such a body of work there?
Sometimes it's less an individual moment, but especially a story like Sigismund's during the time of the Great Crusade works because of everything we know afterwards. The clash between Sigismund and Khan, later Khan the Betrayer, during the Siege of Terror, and what the World Eaters become is well known. But then that makes it even more interesting why actually the World Eaters are one of the legions that Sigismund feels closest to. He has the closest bonds with, and you just end up going, well, why? Because even during the Great Crusade, they were pretty savage, but Sigismund still has this bond with them. A closer bond than he has with maybe other legions that are more that you would expect that would be a more natural sort of like fit. Why is that?
And when you'd worked on books featuring Sigismund and some of his fellows before, did you have any sense of what his very early life would have been like or must have been like? How long have you been taking notes for this sort of endeavor?
Ages, to be honest. You start off with scraps from all the other little allusions that people have made over time. So we knew that he was from Terra. I think even when I first wrote anything for Sigismund, which was in The Crimson Fist, I made an offhand comment about the Ionis drift camps. And I returned to that a few times in the other times when I wrote him. So I knew pretty much as soon as the first time I wrote him that he was from Terra, that he grew up in this kind of, in these camps. But other things, you sort of go back and you find little allusions and interesting things to put in. So one of the things I wanted to show was him being made a space marine. So the process of being taken, assessed, selected for one legion, I wanted to really show that process. There's also this tantalizing possibility as they're going through. If you're like, well, what if he'd gone to a different legion?
Excellent. Well, that sounds very exciting. We'll keep an eye out for what comes next. And we should probably let you crack on with your next book.
Thanks very much, Ray.
Thanks very much for taking the time, John. See you soon.